Emerald ash borer is the most destructive pest to attack our urban forests. It will kill the vast majority of North American ash trees in our cities, and in some of our cities, as much as 70% of trees are ash. Adults lay eggs in the cracks and crevices of the bark. The eggs hatch into larvae and bore beneath the bark and feed on the cambium. Larvae consume and damage the functional xylem of the ash tree. This feeding starves the tree of water and nutrients and kills branches. Trees are often killed in 1 to 3 years. The bright light in this otherwise gloomy picture is the availability of pesticides that can be used to protect ash trees from EAB. These are injections that poison the adult beetles that feed on the leaves and the larval stages that feed beneath the bark on the cambium. A single injection of insecticides can protect a tree for as many as 3 years. Despite the availability of these tools, it's often difficult to convince communities to take action to save trees. The best time to initiate a control program is when the trees are healthy and they can take up these insecticides through their vascular systems and into their leaves. The trees in this photo are located only 400 meters away from where EAB has already damaged a tree in a parking lot. As you can see, it's difficult to convince communities that their trees are in trouble when they look this healthy. It's much easier to convince people to act when half of the trees have lost a substantial amount of their canopy. By this time, however, it's too late to save the trees from EAB. The goal of our paper was to develop a way to convey the urgency of the EAB problem to communities while there was still time to save trees. We then developed tools to help these same communities use local estimates of cost of treatment and tree removal and replacement to economically justify their management decisions.
So our approach to this problem was to characterize the decline of the urban ash forest. We then developed a non-destructive sampling approach to help cities understand where their forests were along the spectrum of ash decline. We think that the decline of an ash forest can be best described by a doubling model. In other words, the number of trees that are affected by emerald ash borer in a given year could be predicted by doubling the percentage of the affected trees in the prior year. So starting with 1% of the trees in year one, we could double this amount until year eight when 100% of the trees were affected. So we found this doubling model could accurately predict the rate at which 14,000 trees had to be removed from the streets of Fort Wayne due to damage from emerald ash borer. In order to help cities preserve their ash trees before they had to be removed, we wanted to see whether we could determine if this model could estimate the accumulation of trees that had lost more than 30% of their canopy. Because this 30% level is when it becomes too late to save an ash tree with insecticides. So to test this model, we identified 50 trees that had lost less than 10% of their canopy to emerald ash borer and another 50 trees that had lost less than 30% of their canopy. And we tracked them over time in two cities. In Lafayette, Indiana, we found that with the exception of 2012, which was a historic drought, we found that the model accurately predicted the accumulation of untreatable trees over 5 consecutive years. In Indianapolis, we found this approach to accurately assess the status of ash decline 6 years after it was detected in the city. But by then it was too late to launch a successful treatment program against the emerald ash borer. Armed with a sampling tool, cities can see where their forest falls on the timeline of ash decline. This can convey the sense of urgency needed to get the public to fund a treatment program before it becomes too late to save their ash forest.
Our model of ash forest decline has been incorporated into our web-based calculator that compares the cost and benefit of different responses to EAB at different stages of the EAB invasion. So by staging the decline of their local ash communities and with local estimates of the cost of tree removal, replacement, and treatment, cities can determine the most appropriate plan of action for their city. Our economic analysis provides hope for cities already affected by EAB. The substantial economic benefits can still be obtained when control programs are initiated in year 5 of the cycle, when about 16% of the trees are damaged beyond the point of saving them.